Hello students, how are you? In this video, I am going to explain chapter 2 of CA Foundation module. Chapter name is Accounting Process. Okay, chapter 2, Accounting Process. Okay, there are actually total 6 units in this second chapter. There are 6 units. And in this second chapter, today we are going to start with unit 1, Basic Accounting Procedure Journal Entries. Okay, to complete this chapter, every student must do the 3 topics in it. And these 3 topics are accounting, equation approach. Where is this? Is here accounting equation approach. Second is rules of debit and credit, and the type of journal. The last one, types of journal. Okay, these are the 3 topics which everyone should know to complete this chapter. Okay guys, let's start with accounting equation approach. What is accounting equation approach? This is accounting equation approach. Let us start. This is accounting equation approach. Okay, what is this approach? Basically, this approach is the backbone of double entry bookkeeping. We should write that accounting equation. Okay, it is the backbone of double entry bookkeeping. Okay, in this approach we consider that assets of business, mind it, assets of business is always equal to total liabilities of business. Total liabilities of business. Why this happen? It will be discussed on later on in this same video session. This accounting equation is given by Mr. Luca Piccioli. Mr. Fra Luca Piccioli. Who is it? He is the inventor of double entry bookkeeping. Because double entry bookkeeping is developed or invented by Mr. Fra Luca Piccioli. He was a famous mathematician in Italy. Basically, he is the inventor of double entry bookkeeping. He was a mathematical professor in Italy in the era of 15th century. Italy, country of Sonia Gandhi. Okay, as all of you know that in mathematics, equations are represented by, equations are right hand side and left hand side. Okay, right hand side always equal to left hand side. Mr. Luca Piccioli put assets of business. Mr. Fra Luca Piccioli put assets of business on right hand side and total liabilities of business on left hand side. Okay, that's why we always write assets equal to total liabilities. Now, what is total liabilities? What do you mean by liabilities? Every business purchases assets either by its own capital or by other parties or by the help of other parties. Let us understand the concepts of liability. Liabilities can be classified in 2 categories. internal liabilities. Payable to owner of business. Okay. By the firm. Or all other liabilities, whether it is internal or external, but not connected with the owner. All other liabilities. All internal and external. Okay. Now, this part is known in double entry bookkeeping as capital, and this part is known as liabilities. When we consolidate capital and liabilities, then we should say total liabilities. So, addition of capital and liabilities known as total liabilities. Okay. So, every business acquire its assets either from the money of capital or either it is acquired from the money obtained by the liabilities. That's why assets are equal to total liabilities. There are some other names of capital. What the other names? Let us understand. Others name of capital are, capital is also known as equity or net worth. You should remember, if you say capital or equity or net worth, all words have same meaning. Now the question is arise. If someone asks you, why do assets are equal to all liabilities? Why do assets are equal to liabilities? Then you know, because assets are required either by the money obtained through capital, or assets are required by the money through obtained by liabilities. That's why always assets are equal to capital, assets are equal to liabilities, or consolidation of capital plus liabilities. That's why total liabilities equal to total assets. Okay. Now let's solve some questions given in your study mat. Let's start. Yes. We start from illustration number 2. Okay. This is illustration number 2. Illustration number 2. Yes. Come on. Develop the accounting equation from following information available in the beginning of accounting period. Now this is important. This is at the beginning of accounting period. Okay. This video tutorial is made for the student who's already from commerce background. So that's why we are not using very initial knowledge. Now capital, it at the beginning is 51,000, loan 11,500, trade payables, fixed assets, inventory, trade as well. Now let us classify it into the capital and liability and assets in 3 parts. Okay. Capital and loan and trade payables are liabilities. So basically these are on left hand side and right hand side. Okay. And these are the assets. So, fixed assets, inventories, trade receivables and cash at bank. Summation of all these come to total assets of the firm. And according to formula, total of assets always equal to capital plus liabilities. What is the capital? 51,000. What is the liability? Let's edit both of them and come to this. It is already solved. Let us see. Capital is 51,000 in the beginning, and liability is summation of 11,500 plus 5700, that comes to 17,200. So we can say assets equal to capital plus liabilities comes to 68,200. So at the beginning, assets equal to capital plus liabilities. Is it clear? Now what should we do? At the end of the year, there are some facts are given and capital is missing. So we have to calculate closing capital. And you are informed that reset the equation and find out profit. It means, first of all, we have to reset the equation, and also we have to ask about the profit. How should we calculate profit? Profit, we can calculate profit by the help of closing capital and opening capital. Okay, but in the last, capital is not given. But there are some liabilities are given and some assets are given. With the help of assets and liabilities, we can easily calculate the closing capital. Once we succeed to get the capital, closing capital, then we can easily calculate the profits. Okay, let's start. Come on. This is the closing capital, which is missing in the question. Closing liabilities, loan and trade payable, that is 11,500 plus 5,800 comes to 17,300. And these are the assets. We can say closing assets. Okay. Fixed assets plus inventory plus trade receivable plus cash at bank. When we calculate all those four, we get this 68,720. Okay. Now what is the capital? Assets equal to capital plus liabilities. Since we know about capital, so we can say assets minus liabilities. Assets are 68,720. Liabilities are 17,300. So we can say it is closing capital is 20,451,420. Okay. Now this is closing capital. You can say it is closing capital. Okay. Now the next thing is profit. How should we calculate? If closing capital is exceed over opening capital, it means profit. In this question, closing capital is exceed than opening capital, so that we know that profit is coming on. Closing capital is 51,420 and the opening capital is given 5100. So we can say 420 is our profit. Now we have calculated the profits. Now the pending is reset the equation. So we can easily prepare balance sheet in this manner. This is balance sheet in the closing. So all the assets are arranged on right hand side and all liabilities are arranged on left hand side. As you know, you are a commerce background, so you know how a balance sheet is prepared. Let's go to the next question, illustration number 3. Okay. In the illustration number 3, Mr. Dravid has provided following details related to his financials. Find out the missing figures. Now what is given? Profit. Profit is given. Now in this question, profit is given. Assets at the beginning and liabilities at the beginning is given. Okay. Now assets are missing in the beginning. Okay. Assets at the end also missing, and liability at the end, it is also missing. But in the last, closing capital is given. Now, if we see, this is closing capital and this is profit. Like in the previous question, we know if profit is given and closing capital is given, we can easily calculate opening capital. So, in this illustration number 3, we can start by this formula that opening capital is closing capital minus profit. Okay. Now in this case, closing capital is 35,000 and profit is 5,000. So we can say that opening capital is 30,000 after subtracting profit from the closing capital. So now this equation is solved, that opening capital is, now we know. Now what is given? Total liability including capital at the end. This is total liabilities. It means not only it contains capital but also liabilities part. So if we subtract closing capital from liabilities, we can get other liabilities. We can get other liabilities. So other liabilities, we should say opening capital and other liabilities in the end is total liabilities minus closing capital. It is in the end. Okay, correct. Now it is, this problem is solved, liability at the end. Now what is the assets at the end? Is we can easily know that assets equal to capital plus liabilities. If assets are ending, that means closing, so capital should be also from ending part, that is closing capital, and also liabilities from the ending part, that is closing. Now we know what is the closing capital and what is the closing liabilities. Both of them at 50,000. It is given in the question. Given. So we can say at the end assets are also 50,000. Easily calculate. So assets at the end, it is calculated. Now assets is the beginning. It can also be calculated by the same formula. How can we solve it? Assets equal to capital plus liability. Asset must be from beginning, capital from the beginning, and liabilities from the beginning. What is the opening capital? This is 30,000. What is the opening liabilities? Okay, opening liabilities is 12,000. We put it 12,000. So we can say that in the opening assets are 42,000. Okay, we have solved it. Now let us check what is the solution. Compute opening capital, closing capital minus profit. Okay, we have already calculated. We also know assets equal to liability plus capital. So therefore, opening assets equal to opening liabilities and opening capital. Once we calculate opening capital, by adding opening liabilities, we get opening asset, that is 42,000, which we have calculated at the end of this, at my copy. Now, accommodation liability at the end. Total liabilities are 50,000 and closing capital is 35,000. So, liability at the end is 15,000. So, we can say assets at the end, summation of closing capital and summation of liability, which is already given in the question. Okay? So, we have covered in this video session accounting equation approach. Now we are ending this video session. In the next video session, we'll talk about the remaining topics. Okay, and what are the remaining topics? Remaining topics are traditional approach, modern approach, and the types of journal. Okay, till then, bye-bye.